Hi, this is Maggie. I'm looking at the chart of the day for Saturday, December 16th, 2017. And it's just a powerful chart today. We have a stellium of planets. There's about eight planets in Sagittarius on the midheaven. And they're all in the, all the planets are above the horizon with the exception of Uranus and Aries. You know, depending on where you have it in your chart, but this is just a chart of the day, a general chart of the day. And this has Neptune in Pisces on the ascendant, but everything is fire and water. It's all about fire and water. So there's just energy to burn. Currently in California, our whole state has been on fire, NorCal and SoCal, and, you know, creeping into Central Cal. So we're praying for rain here. Anyway, Uranus is still in Aries, so sudden unexpected events. And, you know, that can include evacuations, just, you know, sudden, you just don't know how suddenly it's going to change your life, and it's impacting a lot of people. But what really I wanted to talk about is the stellium of planets right on the midheaven, on the career sector. Well, ninth house is the house of Sagittarius, and we have the moon and Mercury, the planet of communication. The moon is, you know, emotions, feelings. So there's just a lot of talk about travel, international communication. Venus, it's a great time to take a trip. I know a lot of people traveling right now. One just came from South Africa, the other's on their way to South Africa. So it's just a great time to travel because Jupiter rules Sagittarius, and you know, it's known for traveling. It's also a good time for higher education, law, legal matters. And with Venus and the Sun in Sagittarius in the 10th house would bring some luck in those matters. Jupiter and Mars are in Scorpio in the 8th house. So giving just intense depth. Predominantly it's fire. We have like eight planets in fire plus the midheaven, all above the horizon in the ninth and 10th house on the midheaven. And then we have, of course, Uranus and Aries is, you know, down here it's on the first house, second house. But Mars and Jupiter in the 8th house, and the trine is to Neptune and Chiron in Pisces. So those are in trine, they're in the same element. So there's no air and no earth today. So people are very, very instinctual, want to get on the move, you know, want to get out and do things. Traveling would be good if you have energy to burn. Inspiration too, just to be inspired to create your new life, because Sagittarians have such foresight and vision. So if you're in the process of creating a project or a new vision for the future, because Jupiter, you know, looks toward the future, the Archer looks towards the future in Sagittarius, and they tend to have a vision for the future. So it's a very great time to look towards your goals, you know, have a vision for the new year. You probably have been building your goals with Uranus and Aries, but with this stellium in Sagittarius, it's so fortunate, you know, it's just, it could be good news. Everyone's happy and shopping, you know, with Venus there. Venus is very happy. The Sun is very happy because, you know, it's all on fire. The only one that doesn't seem that happy is Pluto in Capricorn. That's the only Earth sign today. Actually, it's been there a long time, but this has Pluto in Capricorn, and Saturn is 29 degrees. 29 degrees. Sagittarius, so it's just going into Capricorn. So Pluto, Saturn in Capricorn, going to cause massive, massive changes. And it's just, you know, right now, I think I'm excited because it's about having your vision, living your vision, fulfilling your vision, creating a vision, you know, vision for the future. And then, you know, when it goes into Capricorn, it's going to be, you know, it's going to be 2 years of very, very hard work. Or, you know, maybe you don't have any Earth, so it would give you more attention to detail, or make you maybe a little more business-minded than you usually would be. So, you know, it may just feel like you're plodding along and just have to work very, very, very hard. But the rewards, you know, will come in 2.5 years. The rewards will come when Saturn moves into Aquarius, which is this little 11th house of hopes and wishes and, you know, groups and people, and humanitarian and astrology as well. So it's on to create your vision for the future and where you would like your, because the midheaven is your vision for the future, your career sector. And if you don't have a career, it's just how you are perceived in the world, or where you want to be in the world, or just with so much stuff up there. We will definitely be hearing a lot of international news because Mercury's there, the planet of communication. Venus is there helping her out, Venus and the Sun. So that's very good for travel. But just enjoy all the Sagittarius energy. You know, it's great for parties, having fun, shopping, overindulging in everything, absolutely everything, because all these are, Sagittarius is a very indulgent sign because Jupiter rules it. Jupiter is expansion. So, you know, your waistline could expand but, you know, just have fun while you can. Enjoy this fire sign Sagittarius energy, because it's going to feel a lot different when it goes into Capricorn. And it's just going to feel a lot heavier. And, you know, just going to, you know, it's going to feel the need to get to work on something. Or it's going to maybe feel like drudgery, you know. It's going to be some fundamental changes. But just enjoy this fire. Fire and water. I'm all fire and water. I don't really have any earth. So just to see everything up there on the midheaven in the 10th, 9th and 10th houses is just pretty awesome. Pretty awesome. So take advantage of it and just use this to have fun, or to build towards your future, to build your vision towards the future. Because, you know, when Saturn and Pluto are in Capricorn, it's going to be all business, all work, no play. Make Chuck a very tall boy. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video and have a good holiday season.